Hey guys, Schwagner here. Welcome to a random Dragon Ball Z video with my friend Levi, who is also a big Dragon Ball Z fan. Say hi.
Hello!
Now, I am going to be playing computer versus computer because, trust me, when I get into deep conversations, I don't really focus on the game that much, so shut the hell up.
Unless you want to see Steven get his fucking anus wrecked.
That already happened because, you know, I can't use my control stick for some reason on this emulator. I can only use the D-pad to move. It's riveting. Okay, here we go. So, I feel like I think we're gonna start off with some plot holes that I noticed with the show. First of all, I need to mention this. How can Goku read minds?
Dude, I mean, based off of key and what I've understand of fucking Asians.
Like, do you remember what I'm talking about, anything. Right? Like, you know what I'm talking
fucking,
about.
I mean, clearly the abridged of Team 4 Star has put it the best way. Bored now, reading your mind.
Bored now, reading your mind. Yep, okay. Who should he face? I mean, dude.
No,
why not?
Better plot convenience. Why the fuck can't Elder Kai perform that goddamn, like, whatever, like, Ultimate Gohan or Mystic Gohan, whatever the fuck you go by? Why can't he just do that to Goku, too, at the same time?
Because Goku doesn't have any hidden power.
Dude, fucking Goku don't have any hidden powers saying Goku should never be able to go Super Saiyan.
I'm trying to think of another thing, like, okay. There's a lot of plot holes that involve freaking Gohan. Like, it's pretty bad. Like, how come he can't go Super Saiyan? Like, how come he can't go Super Saiyan after becoming Ultimate? Like, he never does.
He can.
That's Resurrection F. I'm talking about before that.
No, they confirmed that he can. He just doesn't need to.
Well, now he does, because he's a weak baby.
What?
Freaking Gohan's a pushover now. What else?
Yo, just watch. If they force Gohan to, like, start training again, fucking Elder Kai's gonna have to re-unlock his potential.
Yeah, it's too much work, apparently. What else?
Clearly.
Yeah, it's too much work. It takes, like, what, 25 hours? 5 for just getting the ritual started? What else? Also, Ultimate Gohan. I have a question. Since his power level against Super Buu is Super Buu's power level is apparently like in the 20 billions. Ultimate Gohan's is like 32 billion. So how come he gets his butt? How come he just all of a sudden just gets his butt handed to him? Like, all of a sudden, just halfway through that fight, just Super Buu just kicks his ass. Like, you want to talk about that?
He did the same thing he did against Cell, I'm going to assume is what they meant to say.
Yes.
You know what I mean?
Yes.
You know, against Cell, when he was just like, I'm going to be a fucking douchebag and play with this motherfucker.
Well, I mean, I can understand.
Then he realized.
I mean, I can understand Boo had absorbed, you know, freaking Piccolo and Gotenks. Oh, I mean, whatever. Still.
Dude. He was still kicking his ass. The only thing that kicked his ass was the fact that he somehow did the refusion inside of his body, and Super Saiyan 3 Gotenks kicked his ass.
man. I've always wondered something, like, just Dragon Ball, or, not Dragon, what I'm trying to say here, Super Saiyan got Super Saiyan? Like, I'm just saying, straight up, like, can he go, like, Super Saiyan got Super Saiyan 2 and it's, like, he just, like, his hair gets more spikier, and then he just has electricity. And then, could he go Super Saiyan God Super Saiyan 3, where he just has long-ass blue hair, which looks sexual, make him a sexual Tyrannosaurus?
According to Goku, in the translations, he's like, this is my Super Saiyan form, combined with God energy. Correct me if I'm drunk. That means, just add more Super Saiyan, and you get God Super Saiyan 2.
And then, could, what, I mean, obviously Super Saiyan 4 is not canon, but could he become a Super Saiyan God Super Saiyan 4? Just really hairy.
Yeah, he'd be like fucking purple with like the red-blue combining.
Then like his hair would... What would his hair turn? I guess it would turn back to black or something, since, you know, Super Saiyan that
fucking,
happens.
I don't know, red, because it'd be God energy.
Oh, yeah, I guess, but doesn't Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta's hair turn red?
Yep. Because it's basically God.
Yeah. Dude. Oh, just, my gosh. Like, you really think, man. What?
You know what a better question is?
What?
I mean, the fuck would happen if they fuse now?
It would become Super Saiyan God Super Saiyan Gogeta. I mean, that would be just, it's donezo. Everybody would die.
So, Vegeta and Goku fusing is Gogeta fucking, that motherfucker is still non-canon.
I think it should.
Which is fucking gay.
I know. Well, think about it. It technically would happen in the show. Like, they never did fuse with the fusion dance in the show, so technically it would just happen, but if they actually did do the fuse.
No. You know what a better plot hole is?
What?
Why the fuck is it that if you took... that after they become Vegito... and get absorbed by Boo.
How come he doesn't turn into, like, super...
How the fuck do they unfuse?
Because they
die. There ain't no timer on it.
Because... That's a good point. Maybe when you die as a fusion, you separate. Because he did absorb Gotenks.
They didn't technically die.
Yeah, well, he absorbed Gotenks and they unfused. Well, granted, the timer was up for that.
No, they were still fused. So that's what I mean, man.
I don't know.
And not only that... Vegito is technically a zombie.
Oh, yeah.
Because Vegito is dead.
He's half zombie.
So unless Kiri Toriyama is just a fucking drunk and forgot that fact.
Dude, be careful what you say, man. All the fans are gonna, like, try to murder you.
I mean, you can give me shit in the comments, but that's my question. Unless...
Because
he's known for being forgetful.
Yeah, he is.
He's known for being forgetful, so it's like, what? Just did he have a drawing one day of what he drew, and he just forgot the halo on Vegeta, and just assumed he was alive still? Like, honestly.
Probably. Oh, jeez. Trying to think of something else.
I mean, it's ridiculous.
But like, look, I remember there's a thing that you brought up that honestly, I really think what actually happened if Vegito went Super Saiyan God Super Saiyan, or just Super Saiyan God in general, would he be able to defeat Beerus? I think he would.
If they fuse now with their God powers, they should be able to kick his fucking ass. They'd only have like 30 minutes to do it, though.
No, that's Gogeta. I'm talking about Vegito.
Oh, have they remade Vegito?
Yeah.
No.
Really?
They'd be like on an equal playing field.
The thing is though, I don't think that you could really, I don't think that Beerus would go down in a span of 30 minutes.
Well, they do get that, thanks to the fusion technique, you also get a 30% boost or something? Or is it times 30? I forget.
I don't know, but I know Gogeta increases attack or something. I don't know what Vegito increases.
Vegito is just infinite. It get infinite time. That's what it increases.
Yeah, but apparently if you get eaten by a piece of chewing gum, you unfuse.
Yeah, apparently when you go from being God mode, fucking gum attacks you and you become a basic bitch.
Also, I have a question about Gotenks. How many freaking ghost kamikazes attacks, like how many of those ghosts can he make? That's what I want to know. I know in Fusion Reborn, I think it was Fusion Reborn, he made like 100. Like, the fight Hitler, he that was beautiful. I mean, when you witness Gotenks fighting Hitler, it's pretty amazing.
I think when he makes that, he can make him more explosive, but he makes fewer. Cause like in all the ones he.
Okay, now we're back. You can talk. You can finish your sentence.
Back in business.
Yeah, something happened.
Oh.
Oh man, so what were you saying?
That's just my question. It's just like, what in the fuck, Bungie?
I don't even know,
man.
He just
decides. It's like, you know, fucking God mode over here. You get God key.
Dude, I've heard people who say Super Saiyan 5 stronger than Super Saiyan God. Even though Super Saiyan 5 is technically not even a thing.
Super Saiyan 5 becomes like confirmed in the thing. I'd assume it fucking kick Beerus's ass, honestly.
But like,
Goku achieved it, Vegeta would be like right next to him.
Yeah, I know. But the thing is, though, is that I just can't like, I don't know. Apparently, like a Super Saiyan 5 is supposed to be like 100 times stronger than a Super Saiyan 4. But you know, but a god is a freaking god. So I mean, I don't know really how you could freaking beat that.
Well, it's in comparison. Let's see here. Super Saiyan is like what, a 20 times boost of base power?
I don't. How strong is a Kaioken times 20 though? Because you have to like compare it to a Kaioken kind of, and then you'd have to take into the fact a false Super Saiyan. Or a Super Saiyan 0.5, or like a 0.5 Super Saiyan.
Well, Kaioken times 20 was clearly a fuck ton weaker than Super Saiyan.
Oh, yes, obviously. I know a Great Ape is like, what, a Super Saiyan, or not a Super Saiyan, just a normal Saiyan times 10,
wait,
I think is what this
now,
Great Ape
now that
is.
I think about it, I think Super Saiyan's 50 times.
I don't know.
So
I bet you it changes over time because Kakeru Toriyama doesn't really give a shit.
Well, no, because technically he said he confirmed there's 3 stages of Super Saiyan.
Well, 4.
The first one that was the fuck ton of power of these transformation, and you kind of lose control of yourself.
It's a pretty awesome move. Then there's what Vegeta just did.
Then there's what Goku and Gohan did in the Time Chamber, was version 2, where they're stronger.
Okay, then that just happened.
But I mean, they stayed in it so long that transformations for them is nothing.
Mhm.
And then there's 3 where you know you're bulky as fuck.
And then, well, you forgot about the. Are you talking about like how like in the hyperbolic time chamber the whole entire like getting buff as shit thing?
They, yeah.
Well, they're also, like, I mean, after that, apparently, you can just stay Super Saiyan in your normal life, just, your hair is freaking yellow, which is called,
yeah,
like,
that's
a
what
full
stage 2 was.
Mm-hmm.
They figured out how to withstand all of it, so they can transform it with, like, no power. Then came Super Saiyan 2, which, unless I'm a drunk, should be 4 times, or, yeah, I believe it's 4 times, from Super Saiyan. You think you're ready to face me? So,
oh, I mean, jeez, then, man.
Then people were claiming Super Saiyan 3 is like 8 times, which from Super Saiyan 2.
Mm-hmm.
And
I
if that's true, you should have kicked Boo's ass with a.
Should, dude.
A
I just well, he said
effort.
Goku said that he could have beat Boo when he was like fat Boo at Super Saiyan 3, but he wanted the, you know, the boys to fuse first and try to beat him.
Yeah, he fucking Goku got problems, man.
Yeah, he's like, I always want to give all of my people a chance. Goku's kind of retarded sometimes.
It's like, yeah, I'm strong as fuck, but I mean, I want everyone to have an opportunity.
Am I like in the abridger, like, please do not make a habit of that. Oh, no promises. Oh, dude, I just remembered another plot hole with freaking Gohan that just doesn't make sense at all. It happens like 4 times.
Mm.
How much hidden power does he have? Because he got his hidden power unlocked by Guru, which was like, you know, as a kid. And then he got his hidden power unlocked when he became Super Saiyan 2.
From what people have understood so far, he means, like, your current hidden power at that moment.
I know, but still. But still, like, and then it happens again because he's like, I realize I could go Super Saiyan 2 without, like, unlocking and getting really pissed off now.
The more training he got, the stronger his latent abilities became.
But then how come the other Sea Fighters never did anything like it? Like, how come Goku isn't like, unlock my hidden power? I probably have, like, 50 hidden powers.
Clearly, according to everything Goku has done so far, he has to do it himself. He don't want no fucking handouts.
He doesn't want... Remember, yeah, that is true, because remember he was like, when he became Super Saiyan God, yeah, I really love having this much power, but it's not mine. It kind of pisses me off. Like, you ungrateful...
Exactly.
You ungrateful little piece of shit. I still love Goku, but still.
I don't
fucking
blame him, dude.
I mean, I can see why, but I mean, jeez, man. Not crap.
He's like, I only fucking did this because you're gonna destroy my planet. I'm like, eh?
Okay, then.
I mean, how many times has your fucking planet been destroyed and you guys just go after, like, Namek and get it rebuilt? Goddamn.
Also, I mean, I have a question. You know how they went to the hyperbolic time chamber for Cell?
Yep.
How come they never went to the hyperbolic time chamber for the androids?
Because Mr. Popo.
Probably. Oh no, the plot convenience wouldn't allow for it, because then they wouldn't probably have enough time to do it with Cell.
Do it.
Do it.
That, and they had a lot more time though.
Yeah, I know, but still.
I mean, they had a year's worth of time or so to figure out a plan.
It's just my
fucking
gosh.
Ridiculous. It's like, plot convenience. What should we do? Oh, we'll give them a year's worth of training.
Huh.
Okay, now we give them an enemy they have like 6 days to prepare for. And we'll give them a fucking magical room.
For bullshit. I mean, it also explains, I mean, why can't Vegeta ever go Super Saiyan 3? I don't freaking know. It's a bunch of bull crap.
Because Goku needed to go Super Saiyan 3, you have to push your body beyond its limits and essentially shortening your life. But you know, since you were fucking ghost, you can't really kill yourself like that.
How come Vegeta didn't do it and he was all... dead?
Dude, because he was sent to hell, remember?
Oh yeah. Wheel balls. I'm not surprised by that. I mean, I'm not gonna question Vegeta not going to hell, because, you know. He's Vegeta.
How many fucking planets did he claim he destroyed?
Oh, we gotta do fusions about to happen. Go! Oh! 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 It's riveting. Jeez. Also, how come in GT, I haven't finished GT, but does Gotenks ever appear in that?
No, he does not.
Why? They're like, we should use fusion! No, not yet. Seriously? Like, why? Why? I want, of course, Dragon Ball Heroes.
They actually said that we could fuse.
No,
I'm pretty sure they mentioned that somewhere. They're like, we could fuse, and then it'd be fucking pointless.
I think it was the Baby Saga.
It's like, but we could fuse, it'd be pointless, and I'm like, it's not wrong.
But still, it'd be cool. I have another dude. Also, Dragon Ball Heroes. You know, have you ever seen the footage of that game?
God, no.
It's my god. It makes you jealous of Japan.
Why?
Just, I don't know how to explain it, man. I mean, you get to play as basically every single character ever created, all their forms. But it's basically, you know, in Japan, apparently card games are like super freaking popular, but you have to buy cards for this stupid arcade machine. But, you know... But it has like every single character, even like characters that shouldn't even
exist. I know exactly what you're talking about.
And like all the cutscenes are animated. It's amazing and I want it in America.
Yeah, they have that Yeah.
Super. Okay. Super Saiyan 3. Goten.
I have a better question.
What?
Was Goten born without a tail?
No, I'm assuming. Well, no, I just assume they cut it off at an early age. Also, when was
Trunks was born without one?
Maybe some half-breeds just don't grow a tail.
Fucking Gohan, that motherfucker, like three of them throughout the series. Well, counting a movie.
You know what I also don't get is how does the consequences of regrowing a tail even, like, happen? Because Gohan and Goku grow it back a few times, but Vegeta, it's like, when it's gone, it's gone.
No, they legitimately said as a baby, or like a younger fucking child, you can get the shit kicked out of you, you can sometimes regrow it. I'm like,
okay.
What in the fuck? Like, who just like takes their child, beats the shit out of them, and like, ah, shit, my tail's back.
And also, like, remember in Tree of, like, Might, the
just,
most...
No, just like imagine... No, okay. Just like imagine, like, fucking... Raditz and Bardock, like, in the fucking, like, living room of a house or something, comes running in there, like, hold his tail, like, Dad, I lost my tail!
Bardock hold, just, like, hold still, son.
Punches the hold shit out of him.
No, it's be like, hold still, son. Okay, your tail's back.
Exactly, that's what I'm saying.
Well, that also technically would raise their power level, because if a Saiyan is beaten to near death, his power level will go up to, like, very high for some reason.
Dramatically.
It's right here in the Saiyan, like, handbook.
What?
It's like, my gosh.
Dude. And not only that, it's confirmed that half-breeds can have it happen, but it doesn't always happen. So, I mean, that's when you watch the series and you see Gohan get the shit kicked out of him. Like, during the Saiyan Saga, where he got the shit kicked out of him for, like, three fucking times in a row. And then he gets his Zenkai boost and grows a fucking tail. And I'm like...
Zenkai boost! You notice how when he became an adult, he stopped getting Zenkai boosts? Like, am I the only one that's noticed this?
Yeah.
Like, am I the only one who finds it a little bit weird? I mean...
Dude.
My gosh. Goldal! I'm also questioning how come spirit bombs never worked on anything else but Boo. I mean, it can't kill Vegeta, but it can kill Boo.
Well, no, it kicked Frieza's ass.
But he was still alive. I'm talking about, like, just straight up murdered him.
It's because he only took the energy of, like, fucking Namek.
Good point. What would happen if he took up the energy of the entire universe?
Well, that's what he did to Boo.
I thought it was just Earth.
No, he called up, like, the fucking... Was it only Earth? Because, I mean...
I don't remember.
If it was only Earth...
No. I remember how it worked. I remember how
Earth
it worked.
Got knocked the fuck out?
No, here's how it worked with Namek. The people are already dead, so none of the people gave the energy, so it's just like the freaking, you know, planet itself. Plus, the planet was kind of going to go boom. And then, of course, on Earth, every person...
Fortress.
They wished every person back to life on Earth. And then they were like, people of Earth, raise up your hands, give me a freaking energy.
No, they used, they revived everyone on all the planets when Goku was making that fucking bomb.
The bomb of the spirits. Yeah. I'm trying to think. Also, when did this might sound a little bit, like, you know, immature, but, like, seriously, when did Goku and Chi-Chi have sex to have Goten?
I'm gonna assume during his, like, fucking 6 days of rest before, the tournament.
You know what would be really awkward? If it turned out she, like, raped him when he was, like, sick in the freaking bed? That'd be really awkward. Like, I don't know if I
it
can...
Would.
It would be very awkward.
No,
I mean,
you know what another
right.
plot convenience thing is?
You mean a plot inconvenience
Just
or convenience?
Convenience.
Okay.
It's just amazing as all hell. Saiyans can survive in any atmosphere.
No, wait. I remember first in the series, they're like, we Saiyans cannot breathe in outer space, but Bardock, he survived for some reason. Because he's Bardock.
Fucking, that motherfucker held his breath like a mofo.
You notice how we just, like, wrecked, like, he's apparently supposed to be, like, one of the more weaker Saiyans, but he just wrecks, like, half of Frieza's army.
Do you know Bardock became the strongest Saiyan before the planet was destroyed?
That's his bullshit.
He had a power level of 10,000, I'm like...
But remember
correct me if I'm drunk.
Remember, technically he's tied with Broly then, because Broly was born at the power level of 10,000. And Broly was born around the time Kakarot was born.
You know, fucking 4 days before the end of the fucking planet.
Amazing! Also, I want to see King Vegeta go Super Saiyan just because I don't know why. I just think it would be funny. Also, no, here's another plot convenience. How old is Vegeta's brother?
Well, when they destroyed planet Vegeta, he was like... Vegeta was like 12. So...
I thought Vegeta was younger than that, but like... I thought Vegeta was like... Like 10 or something. Or like... Like
well, maybe
6.
They just sent him away as a baby as well.
No, I remember it. No, I freaking remember. It was like...
You know, maybe he got his mother's genes and grew up to be a bitch.
He probably did! But like, when was this kid born? Like, and how did he live through the planet Vegeta destruction? Or unless he's a half-breed, but I don't think he is.
You remember what he said?
I haven't
Vegeta
seen that.
Straight up said, we sent him to clear out fucking no man's land. Who's weaker than fucking Kakarot?
That's
a
actually
fucking disgrace. We sent him.
He was weaker than Kakarot. And Kakarot was born like a power level of like what, 2?
Of like 1,000 maybe? I don't know.
No, it was like
maybe
it was
weaker.
Like, I think it was like 10. That's pretty pathetic.
Like a few hundred or so.
That's pretty pathetic.
Fucking born with a he was born like a human child, born with like a fucking power level 0.002. We were like, fuck that thing.
Yeah. He's a disgrace to our family. Oh, here comes Raditz. Raditz is here to save the day. Oh man. Oh jeez. Oh jeez. Also, was Raditz more powerful than... Actually, I'm pretty sure Raditz was more powerful than Kakarot when he was born.
No, they were both sent away, but... That's how they survived. They were sent away.
Raditz was with Nappa for a little bit. And Vegeta. I think he was for like a little, but you know, whatever.
Well, yeah, cause, I mean, they worked for Frieza.
It's just my god. Also, I think the biggest plot hole of all time that everyone talks about is how the heck did Frieza's blast send Bardock back in time? And also, would that mean that everyone else, like all of Frieza's soldiers that were caught in that blast, were they sent back in time? And if that's also true, weren't all the Saiyans that were on Earth or on planet Vegeta also sent back in time? Like, I'm just thinking.
Wouldn't it also be true that fucking Bardock should have been sent back as well? Like, Bardock should have gone back in time to that point. Is that and became the first Super Saiyan?
Which apparently is like, and then Lord Chiel is like, just warn all my descendants to like be scared
that
of blonde freaking Saiyans.
Bardock should have been the first Saiyan. So he should have been, he's technically the source of all Saiyans.
It doesn't, but that movie's not canon as shit.
Does that mean like he reproduced children with them fucking gloopy things and then made them inbreed until the gloopy fucking shit was gone, so it was just pure Saiyans left?
But then how? When did the tail thing be? Oh, never mind. But like when? What? No, I'm so confused.
The movie confuses me.
Wow.
Or did they, like he have to like reproduce a child? Hope it was female, and then reproduce with it until it was only Saiyan DNA left?
This is getting a little bit awkward, let's stop talking about that. Let's just stop. I'm gonna pause recording real quick. Okay, we're back, but... oh my god, wow. I never thought of it that way. Holy crap, that movie. It's just like Tree of Might. That movie's so non-canon, it hurts.
I don't even remember what Tree of Might was.
It was with Turnless.
I don't even remember.
It's the good
motherfucking insane armor that's like gray as all hell.
Turnless Goku. Kind of worries me. It's like he looks like Goku. So like, but it's like how many characters did Akira Toriyama just get really lazy? He's like, I need to just make a new character. Give him Goku's face and hair. I mean, we have Bardock who has Yamcha's freaking scars. We have Goku, young Goten, who else? Turnless. I just wondered, like, you know, that movie could have been better. Like, this is what Goku would be if he still turned evil. Or if he just also never went out in the sun and had, like, a weird disease where, like, his skin turned gray. It just, oh my gosh. I mean, I just don't get it.
No, it was weird. The fucking thing that was weirder, though, was the fact that he goes, I am your cousin. Terrible.
Are they actually cousins in that?
Yeah.
I don't remember that.
I believe so.
Nah,
I'm drunk.
We might be
probably
wrong.
Both.
We might be... Yeah, probably.
Dude, I mean, what if they're fucking cousins? It's just like...
That'd be really awkward.
Are there like just like gray-ass Saiyans out there?
You know what would be really awkward? If Turtles was somehow the son of Grandpa Gohan?
Oh my god.
Also, how many Saiyans freaking survived the blow up of Planet Vegeta? Holy crap. Also, another plot hole. Remember when they made a wish? Everyone who's been killed by Frieza and people who work for Frieza must be brought back to life. So, how come Bardock and all of his people didn't come back to life? I think I just answered my own question because, like, doesn't the dragon
say
the person's died in like 1 year's time, you can get brought back to life? Or if natural freaking causes.
No, I thought they only asked for Namekians. But he also.
No, wait. Crap.
Natural causes my ass. God damn.
Was it unnatural? It was either natural or unnatural. I don't remember which one it was.
I think it was unnatural because I mean, think of how many times they fucking killed Goku.
Well, Goku never. Well. When Goku came, how did Goku come back? Oh yeah, remember like old Kai gave Goku his life?
Sacrifice
so that's how he
himself.
Came, that's how came. He came back later. Honestly, when you really look at it, this show is not perfect, but oh my gosh, there are some things that I question on that I just don't know, man.
But Swagner, I mean, it's clearly logical that the Supreme Kai could give his life for Goku. It's like,
yes.
No, it's completely logical it's completely logical that Bardock went back in time because the shock of the right. Shut the hell up. Also, whatever happened to his seeing in the future in that movie?
Who?
Bardock. Whatever happened to him seeing the future? Someone want to tell me this?
Apparently, he can only foresee the fucking destruction of his own homeworld.
Apparently.
Oh, and not only that, Bardock is one of the few Saiyans who had ever experienced love with his wife.
Good
but
point.
Apparently, you know, he still has fucking children, was like, fuck you.
I thought you were special, Kakarot, and yet he finds out, my son Goku kills freaking Frieza. Wow.
Kakarot kills Frieza.
Ain't that sweet irony if I've ever heard it. My gosh, that movie. Episode of Bardock.
I love hearing them doctors, though. They hear fucking Goku crying as a child, and he goes, oh,
that's a cry of a warrior!
I'm like,
that's a cry of a warrior! I remember that, they're like, that's the cry of a special warrior! It's like, no.
Dude.
No. Just no.
That there's the cry of a warrior, I'm like, no.
No.
That's the cry of a child who has been birthed recently.
And also, who still has baby penis. Oh my gosh. Also, this is oddly something I've never heard.
Have you seen the, during the Buu saga? Goku, Trunks, and Goten took a bath together. Alright?
Oh, wait. Wasn't that... I remember that.
It's
that
not
was
the
really
first
weird.
Time we've seen Goku do this with, like, Gohan or something, so... That didn't surprise me at all. No, it's the fucking fact that they go Super Saiyan during, like, a flash fight. And then, literally, the entire cast of people...
Just
that are
see
good
him naked.
Fucking jump, and they're all laughing. I'm like... Is this just everyone seeing Goku's penis enough just to be like, oh, it's just Goku?
No, I remember that scene, Videl's like covering her eyes. Like, Videl's covering her eyes. It's like, I mean, I know she's looking at, like, her freaking future husband's dad's penis, her father-in-law, but, like, gee. Also, I ever. Never mind. I was like, if hair grows
like,
when you
oh
become
God.
A.
Oh, God, and everyone else is like, ah, Goku's.
Oh,
back.
That's Goku, and he's Chi Chi freaking the heck out for obvious reasons. And then you just see Vegeta off in the corner, he's like, I hate my life. Because you know they were naked, he's like, Gotenks, get your freaking clothes on! Because they became Gotenks for some reason.
Because they won the splash fight. I'm like, what?
I have a question. Once again, this might come in as immature, but if you become a Super Saiyan 3, would your pubic hair grow?
Oh.
Also, there's another thing.
No, you fucking noticed though? I mean, apparently when you go Super Saiyan, it heats up your piss. Cause they literally were pissing and they were covering their name in rocks.
Oh yeah, it's like, I'm gonna try my right, my name! T-R- Your name, you idiot! Oh. It's just also, I mean, I have to mention it when Trunks pisses on Broly in the second Broly movie.
I know. That was weird.
That was weird as hell. Oh, jeez. Oh, man.
I love how, like, Chi-Chi's freaking out, and then Videl's covering her eyes, and everyone else is like, fucking Goku. Vegeta's over there, god damn it, boys, put on pants at least. And I'm like...
I remember, the narrator's like, everyone's enjoying their lives. Well, except for someone, pans over to Vegeta. Vegeta's like, what are you looking at? And then there's the credits.
I know, it's amazing.
I just imagine then that, like, a narrator just, like, going around with a camera through all of these events. Kind of like the guy from, like, the World Martial Arts Tournament. Amazing.
No, you know what's even better plot convenience?
What?
What the fuck happened to Oob?
What do you mean?
Because he was at the end of Dragon Ball. Like, he's technically canon.
Dragon Ball Z, yeah, he's a reincarnation of Kid Buu.
He's canon as fuck, but you know, fucking fucking Battle of Gods happens after the Buu saga, so this motherfucker's canon.
Maybe he's not canon in the movie universe.
No, because the movie universe just became part of it. The God movies, anyways.
Wait, no, I don't think they are, because then they're retelling the Resurrection of S. They're retelling the... Okay.
Super's remaking, they're retelling it, but it's basically the same.
Oh, well, no, I don't know. I'm waiting for Super to come out in America, which they have confirmed it, I think. So...
Just watch it subbed, like everyone else. It looks like episode 6.
I have told you multiple reasons why I do not watch subtitled versions of Dragon Ball Z. Mostly because I don't...
read.
No, I kind of want...
Fucking
for
read
Dragon,
that
no.
shit and read.
No, for Dragon Ball Z, like, the fast-paced crap, like, it's just... Ow, I can't bother... My mind can't handle it.
It's not that fast.
Well, still. And then, like, oh my gosh. What else? And I can't stand... Every time I hear Goku's Japanese voice, I want to kill myself.
You know Kiryu Toriyama picked out the voice actor because he thought that's how Goku should sound?
He's... No offense, but... No. Just no! Gosh, no. That's a... No. I'm fine with all the other voices in Japan, but that voice pisses me off.
Dude, have you ever noticed fucking, like... There's Vegeta?
Wait, we're gonna pause
he's
real quick.
Bad.
And, okay, now what were you talking about?
There's Vegeta when he's evil, and then there's Vegeta when he's good. Fucking evil Vegeta. I've come to kill you, Goku! Fucking good Vegeta. Yo, Goku, the fuck?
I also like, hate you.
Did someone just like grab your nutsack and just like yank it to the floor? Is that what Bulma does to you during like?
I don't want to know what. I don't want to know what happens with them. Like I don't. Also, when was Bola conceived, or whatever that chick's name is?
Bolas or Bola?
I don't know how you pronounce her name. I think it's Bola or something like that. I know she's named after underwear, because the whole entire family is, besides Vegeta, who's a vegetable. And then I find out what Broly vegetable is supposed to be, and I'm like, wow, I honestly should have known that.
What is it?
Broccoli.
Man, this is a fucking Bardock to be broccoli or something.
I don't know. What is, and then, like, Krillin's named after some kind of nut in Japan.
Yeah.
Dude, there's this one game where, like, you get a scouter and, like, you know, Marin or something? Like, you know, Krillin's old girlfriend?
Oh, yeah.
If you do a scouter on her, it says, it's weird because this life form seems to have no brain waves. The scouter must be broken. It's just like,
so
yes.
True.
I don't remember
Dude,
the name of the
girlfriend
game.
Girlfriend looks similar to Bola.
Bola, or you mean Bulma?
No, I meant the daughter. Cause the daughter's looks like a stripper. And,
we'll see.
GT.
Good point. Well, granted, I mean Marin has that ass.
The shakes left. Wait.
Okay, guys. There's one more thing I want to bring up, and then that will be it for this video. I know it's gonna be a long one, but I've yet to hear one person on the internet talk about this. So you know how a golden great ape is a Super Saiyan freaking golden or great ape, right?
Yes.
Since they have god powers now, what would happen if they went great ape? Would it be like a god great ape or something? That would just be blue, a blue freaking great ape? Like, what would happen?
They went golden ape now?
Yeah. Brandon, golden
G
ape's not canon.
The motherfucking G.
Like, I just now wondered that. Guys, whatever. I guess that is this long video with Levi. Say goodbye, Levi.
Fuck you.
You don't have to listen to me, man. But I'm swearing now. See you guys in the next adventure. Bye-bye.